Welcome back to another video about a new Excel dashboard template. This time we will be discussing the social media dashboard Excel template, which is designed to consolidate the relevant metrics across the different social networks and then compile them into a single page summary dashboard. If you're running a business and you're trying to come up with a single view of the impact on the performance of the business due to the content that you posted across all the different social media channels, then you can use this template to create that single page view. This template does not automate the data collection process from these social networks. However, once you have the data, then you can paste that data into this template to create the dashboard instantly. Now, in this video, we will go through how the dashboard works and how you can use this to create your own social media dashboard for your business. And you can download this dashboard template for free from Indzara.com. Now let's go and take a look at the dashboard. So now I have the dashboard open, and this is the dashboard template with some sample data filled in so that I can illustrate how the dashboard works. So we have the instructions in the settings sheet. We have some links to the blog post, which will have the free download of the template. And so the first thing we want to do in this dashboard template is to select which social networks that you would like to display in the dashboard. And you can choose from these 8. And if you don't want any specific network because it's not applicable to your business, then you just uncheck the box and you're good to go. And the second step is to actually select the thresholds for the percentage change for each of these metrics. So we have 7 metrics that the template will automatically calculate, and you can set the thresholds here. And when we go to the dashboard, I'll highlight how the thresholds actually work, but you can customize the thresholds according to your business. Depending on the size of the business and the scale of the social network that you have in each of these channels, the thresholds could vary. So you have the option to customize the threshold, one for each metric that we have. Okay, so now let's go to the data sheet, which is where the data we have on a monthly level for each of these social networks will be entered. So we have here the month, and then I have entered some 9 months data, and the Facebook columns are here. So for Facebook, we will enter the number of page likes that we had, and this is cumulative page likes, and the number of posts that we published in each month, number of likes that we received for those posts, number of shares that we received from those posts, number of comments on those posts, and number of conversions. Conversions here would be varying depending on the type of business that you have. Conversion is nothing but any specific action that you want the user to have taken, which would ultimately result in success for your business. And it could be whether it's signing up for a newsletter, or it could be actually buying something from your business. So it could be anything depending on what your business is focusing on. That's what we would enter in the conversions column. The revenue is actual dollar or whatever currency you use, the revenue amount that was generated through those posts from Facebook in this case. And this can be tricky to get, and if you have it, you may be able to get it from the web analytics tool, and once you have it, you can just paste them in here. And similarly, we have columns, same exact type of columns for each of the 8 social networks, and we have all the way over YouTube, Google+, LinkedIn, blog, Pinterest, and Instagram. So these are the 8 social networks, and one of them is actually a blog, which could be a blog that you have on your business website. And so all of these are entered here, and you can once you compile the data in another sheet, you can paste them here as values, or you can just directly type if you only have a few pieces of data to enter. And as with every month, you can enter a new row. So for example, if I want to add October's data, so what I'm going to do is to type October 1st, and then that automatically gets added here as a new row. So make sure that you add it in the right place. So don't add any new row. For example, if I type something here, it's not going to get added as a a row in the table, we need to make sure that we add it in the immediate following row after the end of the table. So right now the table ends in row 14 and we want to make sure we enter in row 15. If you want to delete a row, just right click on it and then say delete table row. So this is how you would delete the row. One key thing here is that do not edit the column labels here. For example, I have Facebook audio audience count, FB posts, FB likes. Please do not edit this row 4. That's very important because otherwise the formulas will break in the dashboard. You can definitely rename these things. I have provided my reference so that, for example, we actually would say posts in so that it's consistent across all the social networks. However, Twitter may actually call it as tweet. So that's why I have the reference here. You're welcome to change these things, but please do not change the row number 4, which is used in the formulas. So that's where we would enter the data. And now let's go and take a look at the dashboard. So this is how the dashboard looks. At the top, you have all the different 8 different social networks. And if in case, for example, if we had selected, we don't want to display YouTube, let's go back to the dashboard. You will see that the YouTube disappeared and we only have 7 and everything updated automatically. So that is the flexibility that is built in, where you can choose up to 8, but you can choose any number among these 8. Now let's go back to the dashboard. We have only a couple of controls here. So one is the month. So right now we are looking at the March month's data. And now if I want to look at April, I do this, everything updates, we're good to go. Now the numbers here, we have the metrics lined up here, the 7 metrics lined up here, and then we can see them across each of the social networks. And the first number we see for each metric is the, right now we are looking at the absolute volume. So 53,000 page likes as of April. So that's what we have as the audience count. And the change month over month is displayed here, which is, changes increase of 1%. And this is below the threshold that we have set. And that's why it is not, turning up in a green color, even though it's a positive change in audience count. However, LinkedIn and blog and Pinterest, they have increased in audience count by more than 10% more than 10%. So that's why we see them lit up in green. And we can see in the settings where we had set the thresholds for the audience month over month change, it's 10%. And so if, for example, we can change it to 2%, then when we come back to the dashboard, we will see that more things are highlighted in green because we have reduced the threshold for change. So you can control, according to your business needs, what the thresholds should be. Okay, so that's where we have the dashboard update automatically with a month over month change. Same thing applies to each of the metrics, each of the 7 metrics across. Okay, so the one more control we have is the volume. Instead of volume, we can see the rate per activity. So you will see these things, these 5 metrics change. And that's because we are saying the applause rate right now, instead of it being applause, let me show back again this volume. This is applause, but when we do per activity, it changes to applause rate. And this is nothing but the number of applauses divided by the activity that we did. So we did 20 different Facebook posts. So that's on average 3 applauses. So let's go back and do the volume, and then we will see that there are 60 is the number of applauses. So 60 divided by 20 is 3.0. So that's the applause rate. The similar concept applies to amplification rate, conversation rate, and conversion rate as well. And then also revenue per post. So all of these things are now reflecting per activity, and we can change this to any month and everything updates. And you will see that the metrics that are not exceeding the thresholds we set will be grayed out a little bit versus the metrics that are either exceeding the thresholds either in the negative direction with a red downward arrow or a positive direction with the upward 37%. So both of these things will now actually be shown more prominently than the other metric. So that's the the purpose of the dashboard is to highlight specific metrics that need our attention and action. So either it's extremely high so that we want to understand why, you know, that actually has worked, or it's extremely low so we want to understand what went wrong. So this will serve as an initial starting point to figure out which direction we need to go and further analyze, you know, our performance, either it's for the better or for the worse, so that we can improve the metrics in the next month. Okay, so this is all that the dashboard does. It's very simple, two controls. Every month, you can just come in and update a new row for the new month, and then you are good to go. You can, you know, change the month then, and then print or export to this sheet to PDF. This sheet is already set up for print, and so you can just easily print or export to PDF and share with your colleagues. If you like this template, please share with your friends. If you have any comments or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section of this video and also on the blog post. The link will be provided in the description of the video as well. So please download the template from there and then, you know, post your feedback in the comment section. I look forward to hearing from you. Thank you very much for watching this video.